Hey everyone, Michelle Aswear here. It's dinner time, so we're going to show you how to do a really fun, simple dinner that really tastes good. I'm going to make, I use this as a filling in tacos, and sometimes it's just great like on a salad or things like that, but it makes a nice big bulk depending on how much chicken you're going to use. Now before we get started, I kind of want to show you what I'm going to be cooking with this time, on this particular recipe. Normally when I used to cook this, I would cook it in a crock pot, and so it would take hours and hours to cook, but David and my son introduced me to a pressure cooker. And what's really awesome about these electric ones, and there's multiple companies that make them, is literally you have an amazing dinner in 15 minutes. And I have done I've done meatloaf in here. I've taken a whole chicken and stuck it in there. 15 minutes, it's cooked, ready to go. You can put your vegetables, anything you want in here. So it's really a fun thing to do. When I do squashes, I will actually take the whole squash, put it in there, and in 15 minutes, it's all cooked and ready to go, which normally it would take me an hour to cook the same thing. So that's why this has really been a fun thing, and I use it multiple times during the week. And if you're doing bulk cooking, it's great. You can take frozen chicken breast, pile it all in here. David told me just recently he did 7 pounds in there in 20 minutes. So it is really great if you're looking to cook and cook fast. So how we're going to get started is we're going to start with chicken breast, and I'm using certified organic chicken. So I'm a little weird about my food. So you can see that this has the organic seal, and then it is certified organic. So we're going to put this chicken in. Just dump everything in the pot. And then what we're going to do is we're going to add some fresh chopped cilantro. So I've kind of chopped it here. And I kind of like mine not done really fine because I like cilantro. Cilantro is really great. It's one of the best natural detoxifier of heavy metals. So if you have a little child and you want to clean anything up, you know, add it to a salad. Using it fresh as much as possible is really a good thing to do. Now, the next thing I'm adding is this, it's called adobos, I think is how you, I don't know, but these are chilies in this sauce and it tastes amazing. So not sure how to pronounce it, a little goes a long way. I only use 2 of these chilies. It is warm, so it is a little on the spicy side, so you know, be aware of that. The nice thing about this recipe again is you're just dumping everything in a pot. So if you have a crock pot and you want to do the same thing, you can, you just dump the stuff in. I'm using 1/2 cup of fresh squeezed orange juice from an orange, and I'm using about 1 heaping tablespoon of minced garlic. So we'll add that in. I also, because I'm really particular about my garlic, I like a little bit of garlic powder also. So it kind of has different little flavors, and so I use both. So I'm just going to kind of sprinkle that in there. And I am going to add, rinse my hands real quick, that chicken off. I'm just going to add a couple squeezes of mustard because it kind of gives it a little bit of a spice to it or a bite to it. And then a little bit of sea salt and some Worcestershire sauce. I can get it open. I'm just going to use this tablespoon here and just add 1 tablespoon. Now, because I'm cooking in a pressure cooker, you do have to add a little extra liquid. If you're doing it in a crock pot, then you would be done. You'd put it on low heat, let it cook all day. But with pressure cooker, you have to have so much liquid. And what I do love about this is it kind of is like what I had talked about before about poaching, how much I love poached meat. You're using liquid, and the way it's all cooked, it's, you know, you're savoring and sealing in the juices, and all the nutrients are all, you're not losing anything. And so I'm going to add about 1/2 cup of water because that's what's needed for this particular recipe. So we're plugged in. We're going to put the lid on. So we can do this backwards. There we go. Snap it into place. Lock it. Now I got to set the timer. And we're going to adjust the pressure to 70. Okay. It should start doing its little thing. So in 25 minutes, this will be ready to eat, and we will show you what it looks like. Okay, it's finally done, so we're gonna see what this looks like. So, take off this cover, set it over here, and we're gonna go ahead and bring in this chicken. Gonna just kind of break it up, mix it in with this sauce. So, let's see what it's supposed to look like. Smells good, huh?
It does. You're not supposed to talk to the camera guy.
There we go. And so what we're going to do with this chicken is we are going to take it and put it on some taco shells. So again, you can do whatever you like with it. I'll probably shred it a little bit more to get it where I want it. And but this is a great little recipe for if you're looking for something different. You know that you're tired of the same old chicken, you've baked it and done it all different ways. This is a great flavor and it is something different. So that's our dinner for tonight.
It's sitting in a little bit of fluid right there. Does that mean you're going to empty a little bit out and then keep chopping it? Or do you like it really moist?
I want it really moist. So what I'll do is I'll actually take it and take some forks and shred it more.
So that half a cup of water was really educated. You knew that was just enough to where once you smashed all that up, it was going to be the perfect amount of moisture in the chicken.
I probably would have done a little bit less looking at it because this is my first time cooking this in a pressure cooker.
Okay.
So if I were going to make this again, I would use a little bit less water.
And one of the tips that I really like is, guys, you have to have a certain amount of water in the pot to work, right? So when you throw in frozen, acknowledging they are carrying much more moisture, you need a lot less. And essentially the thing heats up and it's gonna start to defrost the chicken anyway before the 5 minutes really takes it for it to steam and seal. So you can put a little less water into it, acknowledging you're always gonna come back and the fluids that were in the chicken or meat, it should be floating somewhat in them.
Right, exactly. So that's just something, like I said, you can do, and like I said, this should taste really good.
What are we going to eat it on?
Well, like I said, we're going to do it on taco shells.
Taco shells.
So I'm going to use some corn tortillas and some good salsa.
Yeah.
Probably a little bit of sour cream.
All right. What about, this would make a great lettuce wrap, too.
You could do a lettuce wrap. You could do it on a salad. There's a couple different ways that you could do it. You could even take this chicken and use it with the zucchini that we made, and it would taste really great, too.
Right, so that would be a little more of a lower carb.
Yeah, or if you wanted to do it over some brown rice, it would be really good too.
Very good. So what you're saying is this is a meal that can be used in a lot of different ways to make it less boring. But it's chicken. How does chicken not get boring?
I get bored with chicken really easy. I can eat red meat and never get tired of it, but chicken, I get bored. So I'm always looking for new things for chicken.
Well, and we appreciate the tips, Michelle. That was three different ways you said it. Not only are we going to put it on some vegetables, we're going to put on some brown rice, we're going to put it in a taco, or we're going to put it in a lettuce wrap. I lied, that's four. And I'm sure you could come up with more. Changing the taste and texture of the same protein by adding some of these fun little condiments you put in enables you to eat the food that is the best fuel, one of the best fuels that is, cleanest,
and to get you the don't leanest.
Yeah, cleanest to get the leanest. That was good. I never heard that one. The reason why she was adding water is because, obviously, it's steam. And so in order to create steam before the cooking temperature starts, it's probably going to take about 4 minutes. So in reality, it does say 25 minutes, but you're going to spend about 4 minutes creating the pressure, and then the timer starts cooking off.
Well, the neat thing, too, is if you guys are doing sweet potatoes or yams, you just throw them all in there. 20 minutes later, you have all your stuff ready to go. You don't even have to poke holes in them or nothing. I mean, it is just amazing. You just wash them, put them in with some water, and boom, your stuff is cooked and ready to go. So
I'll pile in chicken breasts and then throw my potatoes on top.
Yeah.
Now, are you cleaning the potatoes? Are you scrubbing them?
I wash them. Okay. I'll wash them, but I always leave the skin. There is actually, believe it or not, in potato skin, there is a nutrient that helps with appetite suppression. So, you know, whenever you eat potatoes, you really want to eat the skin. You just want to wash them and make sure, preferably you can get organic so it doesn't have the pesticides. You do want the skin because there is the ability for those that struggle with appetite issues or they're finding that they're too hungry or anything. Naturally, potato skins have that. There's actually a supplement that they make it from potato skins, and that's what they use it for.
For the record, how much was your chicken a pound?
It was $5.99 a pound, and I got it at Costco.
Okay, so what do you say to the guy that, and I was one, and I still am sometimes, that doesn't have the $6 a pound to spend on meat when they're walking past a bone-in chicken that is sometimes 99 cents a pound, and then you also have the on sale at Ralph's or Smith's or whatever supermarket you go to, where you can get chicken by the pound and a good chicken breast, and it says natural on it, for as much as $2 a pound or even less.
Okay, you don't want to get me started on the whole natural thing. They put
Yes, I do.
They put natural on a lot of things that are anything but natural. That is just, it's a new marketing phrase. Yeah, the chickens are standing in a barn all stuck together and they can't even move, and the dead ones can't even fall over because there's so many in there, okay? So yeah, they're quote unquote free range, they're natural, but they're really not natural. And so this is what I say. I mean, you have to live within your means and what you can afford. But I have people actually look at their life. I mean, what else are you doing that maybe you could not do and take that money and put it towards your food? The reality is, with a lot of these hormones that they're putting in this food, they're affecting our whole endocrine system. This is the reason why we see so many men and women with hormonal issues. Like we have, this is a real problem. I work with a fertility doctor. We partner out. He sends me detox patients. I send him hormonal patients. And he was telling me that, you know, that this whole hormones that we're adding to our food are creating huge problems with our fertility. It's affecting women and even more so men. Men, we have so many men that when you go in and look at their testosterone levels, they're way below what they should be. I mean, you take a 20-year-old, his levels should be around 800. They're coming in around 2. And their estrogens are really high. So we see this where we're really feminizing our men. And Yeah, not a good thing. You don't want your man feminized.
Okay, you can't use big words either. What's endocrine system?
Your endocrine system is basically your hormonal system.
Okay.
And these are glands that play an intricate part in your overall health. I mean, each hormone in the body, and there's many of them, they send different signals and messages to other parts, and that tells things how to work. When those messages are disrupted and a different message is given, or maybe nothing is given, then we start to see problems. Right now, more than half the women in the country have PCOS, and that's polycystic ovarian syndrome. And this is where the ovaries are not developing normal. They have all these cysts on it. Some of the symptoms people see are hair where you don't want it. Usually, even for some people who have severe, they'll have thinning on the top of their hair, almost like a man that has too much testosterone. And usually their testosterone levels are way above what they need to be. And they don't have a normal cycle. And their periods, if they do have one, are very painful. I mean, there's just a lot of symptoms that go with PCOS, but there's always an insulin connection too. And this greatly affects fertility. So, you know, when people say, oh, you know, does the hormones really matter? No, if it was one chicken, no, once in a while, it's not going to be a big deal. But if you're doing it every single day, that accumulates in your body. And unless you're doing something to get rid of it or bring things back into range, you're not going to feel optimal. You're not going to function properly.
Okay, so to close, what you're telling me is I got all these friends that are doing steroids, and they're spending all this money on steroids trying to help their testosterone or whatever their issues
right.
are. They need more testosterone. We got to have more testosterone in order to build muscle. Whatever, guys. But what you're saying is don't spend the money on testosterone. Spend it on organic chicken.
Well, you know how I feel about steroids. You know, that's a whole nother story in and of itself. But you do. What the quality of food is just kind of like we've talked about before. You're going to pay for it on one end or the other. So do you want to be going to the doctor because you have all these hormonal issues? Or would you and trust me, these doctors are not cheap. Okay, it's like $400 an hour. And so you want to spend your money on your food. And that is really for us. I mean, I don't get to do a lot of different things, but I buy good food.
So to close, we chose chicken today at $5 a pound. What would be another good option for somebody that doesn't have the $5 a pound to spend to choose a meat that they could cook with, a protein source?
You know, if you know someone or you have the opportunity where you know someone that does hunting and you get wild meat, go after that. That's probably some of the best meat you'll ever have just because it's really
Does this sound like you're pro-guns?
I am.
I'll put you on the spot.
All
right. Thank you, Michelle.